മാഷേ അതുത്ര വിഷമമൊന്നുമില്ല വളരെ എളുപ്പമാണ് മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ
one of the easiest celebrity to work with I would say is Shah Rukh Khan
television set is basically it's like a I mean being a TV anchor I'm telling you it becomes a very homely what it's you have everybody everything everybody does I have even carried the thermocol for my own show
there was some word called Netflix in the industry nobody knew what the hell Netflix was and everything one day got a call from Ajay Devgan's office and they were like Ajay is looking for a manager would you like to join in my next is I want to watch Home
Hello everybody welcome to FTQ Nyan Rekha Menon FTQ means face this question today in FTQ plus my celebrity is going to be a special person from Bollywood yes he's from Bombay yeah but he is a filmmaker his films have been screened in multiple very prestigious film festivals pinne celebrity stylist aanu oru vaadu Bollywood stars nu especially oru vaadu Malayali stars nu idhe style idittu so that's a great conversation going to be of course last but not the least he's from a LGBTQ community and I am very happy to introduce Abhinav Singh and of course I would like to introduce him as a CIS woman as well his insta id is quite special it's called item bomb so I am the bomb squad today let's find out Abhinav thank you so much for coming in and I'm so glad that I follow you on insta I keep get all your news from my Malayali film friends so I know that you are a celebrity stylist let's start from there when did you start the I mean it's not a question on when did you but when did you start feeling that you have in it that styling and what made you think that way
so I used to work with MTV and over mm-hmm. there we used to have a really small team of people to put a show together so we used to do everything right from costumes to art to writing and to putting everything together so that's where it basically kind of came from and it's not a rocket science like you have to just put one and one together
okay
yeah so
but then it's a huge thing no rock I mean this all depends on how a celebrity carries it or even a show host or anybody for that matter
so depends see every celebrity is different every body is different so whenever I am working with a celebrity I always keep the body in mind ki okay she's tall she's short this is the silhouette which will look good on her so that is one of the major deciding factors
okay
when you are giving clothes to somebody and in India like people make clothes for flat women I don't know why so that is one concern which we always face where the clothes are not fitting so but yeah body plays a major part in every styling every celebrity styling
okay so when you were doing everything on your own in MTV you know what was it you wanted to do differently when you started something on your own
See, I didn't know. I was an interior designer, and I didn't know that there will be a point of time where I will have no work, and I will be joining MTV. And that also happened because one of my friends just called me out of nowhere because in my family it wasn't allowed to be a part of the film industry because back in the day, so my. Grandfather used to tell me that you know Prithviraj Kapoor used to come to my house and do nautanki and skits and he was like would you want to go to that industry where these people have come to your house and performed for you
oh my god what a perspective I should have said yes I would love to
I was like oh matlab they are ruling the industry right now and you are doing nothing so first of all it was not allowed in my family to go join the industry so I had to lie to my father for a very long time that I was working in the media industry the only time where I told about my job was when I started working with Ajay Devgan and Kajol and that time suddenly they got validity ki oh he's working with some really big people and all that and suddenly they started telling people oh he works with these big celebrities So that was the first time actually they accepted my job. Before that, I had always lied to them. They never okay. did. They had no idea I worked in MTV. I had no idea I worked in few different other companies. and I worked on TV shows, so they have no idea of all of that.
Okay.
So
from there, when you're moving into, so when from a television set is basically, it's like a, I mean, being a TV anchor, I'm telling you, it becomes a very homely, what it's, you have everybody, everything everybody does. I have even carried the thermocol for my own show because was not there. Ye karo times, because we need, light is going. I can't find another person. We'll do it. From there to a big industry and that to the superstars, you know. So where did you bring a balance to you? Because one, it is, was it real fool or Kante?
So what happened was, when I was working on TV, and that was mostly reality television. And at one point of time, there was no work. There was no work, and digital was just starting. Like, there was some word called Netflix in the industry. Nobody knew what the hell Netflix was and everything. But there was like digitization was happening. Yeah. And we have no, like, a lot of people lost their jobs because what the company started doing was, they stopped hiring senior producers.
Yeah.
They stopped hiring producers. They hired one senior producer and they hired 10 interns under them.
Typical corporate strategy. Yeah.
Yeah, typical corporate strategy. So all the producers like us, we didn't have a job. And all of us during that time migrated into different spaces. So because I, even when I was working with MTV or Colosseum or Meditech, so I was very good with the celebrities. So what happened was, a friend of mine offered me a job to, why don't you come handle some TV celebrities with me? It will be fun. I had no work. I was like, okay. And through that, I one day got a call from Ajay Devgan's office, and they were like, Ajay is looking for a manager. Would you like to join in? And I was like, okay, matlab.
What are you saying?
I was like, okay, imagine. And I joined in, and there was a project going on called Son of Sardar. I have quit in 1 week because I realized I can't work in this space, because everybody kept throwing the weight of their position over there onto me. I am here for 20 years. You don't know what to do. So in a week, I was like, okay, I don't know what to do. So let me go. So after I put my papers down, Ajay has asked me, you know, you're not going anywhere. You're going to work with me. And that's when I started working on Son of Sardar, and I did a few more projects with him.
Yeah.
And he has been extremely kind, and he's been one of the most wonderful boss I've ever had.
Okay. Is he the person very introvertish, not so much, exactly opposite to Kajol, right? When they come on shows, we know that one person is absolutely balancing the other.
He is introverted, but not so much.
Okay. So I maybe in a small circle, he will open up.
Yeah. He is always very open. He always opens up between his people.
Correct. Yeah.
Because when I'm with him, I can't say he's an introvert, because he's talking, he's cracking jokes. He's one of the funniest person in the room when he's there.
And he's a prankster as well, no?
Yeah, he's a prankster. He's an extremely intelligent guy who knows technology and who knows his shit.
Yeah.
Who knows what is happening.
Exactly.
Yeah. And Kajol is a very different person. She's also a very, very intelligent woman. I love Kajol. So she is reading most of the time. She will be reading some, most of the time she'll be reading fantasy fictions and very weird books. And she'll be reading fantasy fictions and, and online shopping. She does a lot of online shopping.
Yeah, I've seen her shows where she will say, "Ye 600 ko mila, ye 1000 rupees ko mila." Times.
Yeah. She used to be very excited when we used to go to Santa Cruz market and local markets here and there and buy things for like really cheap price. Like, as a celebrity, people think, oh, they must be shopping at this only international mall, only big brands, but. She had no such issue. She had big brands and she had small brands, and a very, very grounded person, to be honest.
Before I'm going to the next section of this interview, I want to understand the last question. When you have your manager to celebrity couple, where both of them are equally celebrated people in the country and of course across the world where Indians are, how do you handle that? Because it is basically a pressure cooker actually, right?
See, there is actually when you're working with a celebrity of that stature, the pressure is never on one person. Mm-hmm. There is a huge team. Yeah, there is always a huge team and the pressure is always divided. Right. So to be honest, I never felt any kind of pressure where I was like, okay, now I can't handle this.
Yeah.
And every celebrity is different.
Yeah.
And Ajay and Kajol would be, I would say, one of the most easiest. They have been one of the most easiest people to work with.
Okay.
And they are completely fuss-free. There is no tantrum. They are extremely professional. And they are very,
tantrum
very...
Tantrum nahi hai to, half the problem is over, no?
Yeah, yeah. And they are very, very good people. They are very, very good people. Even the family, as a family, they are very strong and they are very connected. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So working with them was like, it's like working in a family. So yeah. I worked with them for like three and a half years. And it was one of the best experience I've ever had. And to be honest, whatever standing I have in market was after working mm-hmm. with them.
Okay. Now we're coming to the styling. You know, as you said, every body is different. And when you have to handle or make a celebrity understand what is good, how is that? Maybe she or he has this thing in mind where this is what I want to do. But you know that it's not going to work on her. Okay. So how do you handle this conflict? Making her understand this is not for you, darling.
So what I do is I give them what they want. And okay. then I do fittings. And mm-hmm. then on the fittings, I tell them, see, this is what I'm talking about. This silhouette is not working on you. Whereas you should try my silhouette. This is what I think will look good on you. And most of the time they agree.
Which celebrity is very easy to work with, like one or two sessions, one or two options and you're out with a confirmed order?
In terms of management or like general?
General.
General, one of the easiest celebrity to work with, I would say, is Shah Rukh Khan.
Okay.
He's outstanding. I would say even Shilpa Shetty, very good to work with. Ajay Devgan is one of, Ajay is one of the easiest celebrity to work with, and he is so nice. He's very humble, but I would, for me, topmost would be Shah Rukh Khan. Yeah, so he's so humble on set. Even Vidya Balan, I can't
my favorite. Vidya Balan.
Yeah, Vidya Balan. She is so sweet. She is always on time. Even Kajol is always on time. So, one good thing about these actors, they're always on time.
Yeah.
And they finish their work and they go back home on time. And when they go back home in time, we get to go back home.
Everybody, exactly.
Yeah. So, yeah. Vidya is also Vidya is one of my favorite celebrities who I have worked with, and extremely professional and extremely kind on set.
Okay.
She will come and she will say hi, hello to everyone. And when she's leaving, she will say bye, thank you very much to everybody.
Coming to Malayalam movies, I know you have styled some of the stars in Kerala. So what's your take on Malayalam cinema and the stars and your styling experience?
It has been really nice. I am a huge fan of Malayalam cinema. I'm a huge fan of whoever I'm, like Parvati I work with, and I'm a huge fan of her work. I styled Reema for one of the events. She's also a very kind girl and very...
They're all my gang. So sweet.
They're lovely people. They're lovely people. And I'm a big feminist. So I support them regardless. Whatever they are up for, I am also up for it.
Yeah.
So that way we connect somewhere a lot because we share a similar voice. Styling over there is very easy because they're really nice people and they respect my vision. They respect my vision. I have worked with Aishwarya Lakshmi. I have worked with Sanya. Sanya is one of the most stylish girls. Like she can pull off
anything. Carry anything. Huh.
Yeah, she can pull off anything. A very confident girl, and Aishwarya also very beautiful girl, very beautiful face. So it's really nice. Like whenever I work in Kerala, I feel home. I still don't understand the language. It's a very hard language to learn, but I don't understand Malayalam, but And I tried to learn.
I just said it's very easy to understand. I just told in Malayalam. I'm sure the Malus will be laughing now. It's okay.
Yeah. So I will try my best one day to learn the language, because I watch most of the Malayalam films.
Like, uh-huh. Which one was the last?
Last one was Kuruthi.
Kuruthi, very good.
No, film. I watched Brahmam also recently.
Andhadhun
I watched. And my next is I want to watch Home.
Perfect. You'll watch Kane Kane as well, Tobino and Aishwarya's. Aishwarya's done a fantastic job.
Yeah, it's on Sony Live. Yeah, it's on my list.
Yeah. So, that's what, when you talk about your family was not happy when you moved into the entertainment or a movie industry. Then comes your second coming out and you being a CIS gender, which you wanted to pronounce you as a CIS woman.
Yeah.
And how did that happen? And what was the whole scenario behind it? How did your family accept it at this point of time? I'm so happy that you have made that very clear. It came out. And then I've read your experiences in the censor board as well. We'll come to later. But how was this happening?
They haven't accepted it. They have just made peace with it. I'll tell you, for a homosexual person or anybody who wants to identify differently in this country or maybe in the world, maybe. If you're not successful, nobody will let you do that.
Okay.
So you need to prove yourself. Like, if you want to come out somewhere very strongly, you need to prove yourself. Otherwise, people will be like, matlab, you won't have any respect. You won't have any respect. Today, my family has accepted me because I have found my career. I'm doing well for myself. If I wasn't doing well, they wouldn't have accepted.
Yeah.
I know that for a fact. And even today, they haven't accepted. It's just that I have accepted myself. Okay. And I am only bothered about people who accept me. Who doesn't accept me and who doesn't understand me. It doesn't bother me any longer. It used to at one point of time, but not any longer.
I think maybe in this kind of a thought process is more imminent in or even more accepted in a entertainment industry, in an ad or a movie industry. Do you think, or even fashion? Yeah.
Yeah, it definitely is. In any other industry, it is not as easy. I wouldn't be as accepted how I am here compared to anywhere else. Like, here there is no disparity in religion, there is no disparity in culture, there is no disparity in terms of sexuality. You can be whatever you want to. But also this is also very recent. I'll say it was always better than the other industries, but it's not that I have not faced disparity here. When I started my career, it was difficult back then when I was in MTV. People would judge you for your sexual preferences. People would judge you. Like, I have had producers who would not give me equal opportunity because I was not straight. I would be like always made fun of because I was not straight. So I have been through all of that, but it's much better now.
This was like 10 years back, Abhinav.
10 years back, it was not the same.
Yeah. You know, when you look back, what was the biggest turning point in your career, Abhinav? When you're coming out and your professional journey, your stylist and your filmmaking. And your films have been doing extremely raving reviews about your film, has gone across multiple competitions, including Cannes.
So what actually inspired me to make more films was, I did a short film called Chutney with Jiska Chopra. And we worked very closely on that film together. And actually, that was the film which made me understand the whole process of filmmaking. Because before, when I was handling people, when I was managing people, I used to hate going on set, because when you are, as a manager, your work ends in the office.
Yeah.
Rest, everything you can do on phone. I don't even understand why managers have to travel with the actors. When you are when you're on a set and when you're the only person who's not working, it's a really boring process. Shooting is a really boring process, like the setting up and all that. As a manager point of view, I'm talking about.
Yeah.
You don't have much to do. You don't have much to do. You will be sitting around. Din mein teen scenes shoot kiye jayenge, and you will have to sit through it. Yeah. What are you doing? You're chilling there. Some people like it, but I never liked it. Yeah. I never liked it. So when I worked on Chutney and when we did everything together, like everything, like all of us were doing everything. And at that point of time, I understood the importance of everything. And importance of sound, importance of dubbing, importance of color grading. And I realized that there's so much which goes into making a film.
Yeah.
And Chutney became a huge success. Mm. And after that, I decided I want to produce short films. I produce films. Then I produced one short film with Apar Shakti Khurana. That also did well. And I was going to produce the last two ones which I directed. Mm. But what happened was, I couldn't find a director.
Okay.
Yeah, I couldn't find a director. And I was writing these two scripts in the lockdown.
Mm.
And I kept looking for a director, but nobody agreed to do it, thankfully. Okay. Yeah. Nobody agreed to do it. And eventually I was like, I spoke to a lot of my friends, ki what to do? Should I just do it? And they were like, do it.
You have written it. Why don't you do it?
Yeah, you've done half the job. And then I just dived in. And I remember day one, I went on set. I was so nervous. I couldn't even say cut and action. So and my team was so nice and they were so understanding. They were hand-holding me through it.
So sweet.
Yeah. After a few hours, I think after 4-5 hours, I got the hang of it. I'm like, ye karna hai. Matlab, I can do this. Yeah, I can do this. And and that's how I made my first film and it came out good, which gave me confidence to do the second one immediately after.
Yeah.
So I did immediately Sita, right Sita. After Antarvasana. Yeah. Yeah. So I directed both these two films that did really well. Right now I am directing a short for Amazon Mini TV. Planning to go on floor in November, planning to shoot in Kerala only. So.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah. So that's one film I'm doing, and then I'm writing a feature film because
you are on selling, a board, man.
Yeah, then I'm writing a feature film which I'm planning to direct. It's based on my family story.
Oh, nice. That would be great. Why the name Item Bomb?
So it was Abhinav, and then I was like, in between, I worked with this actor called Kajal Agarwal in between.
I know. Huh.
And that time, I got this new hobby of painting white shoes into different colors. And I wanted my brand name to be called Item Bomb.
Okay.
So I changed my Instagram name to that and it became extremely popular.
Yeah. I think Shalin doesn't mind. Your name, Abhinav, is told to me when we had this interview planned. I was thinking your name is only Item Bomb, you know?
No. So this name became extremely popular, like to a point that once I was in Kochi and some random boys on bike started going Item Bomb, Item Bomb. I'm like, what?
Kisko bula rahe
hai? Yeah, matlab, ye kisko, matlab, why do they know me? Huh? And then they followed me. It was damn creepy. And then finally I stopped and they took a picture with me.
That's it.
And I'm like, okay, wait. I'm like, that was damn sweet, but I was like, okay, matlab,
carry also.
I
don't know
why I'm so popular, but it was good. It was good. Yeah. So,
I forgot to ask you my quiz questions. Sorry, yeah. In this conversation, I have two. It's my question. Name two popular directors from Kerala who has made feature films in Hindi.
There is, I think, one Jeetu Joseph.
No. Jeetu Joseph is there, but I said name two directors who made it big in Bollywood.
From Kerala?
Yeah.
The guy who directed Hasi to Fasi. I'm forgetting his name.
He Mr. Mallu, are you're forgetting the big name.
Priyadarshan.
Huh.
Yeah, Priyadarshan. Then
one more I'll give you. Salman Khan film. Salman Khan, Kareena Kapoor.
Bodyguard.
Yeah. Director ka naam yaad hai?
No, I don't remember the name. I don't watch Salman Khan films.
Okay. So yeah. It is a Malayalam film, Bodyguard, which moved, which made in Tamil called Kaval and talking about a film in late 90s, which made it had raving reviews. Also, it went into a lot of controversies. A film by Deepa Mehta. Which film am I talking about?
Fire.
Yeah. See, it's by Hatta Kyo.
Yeah.
I only have two questions, just for the sake of asking a question. But then let me ask you one Malayalam question. Malayalam movie question. Okay. This is your like a rapid fire. Which Malayali star you want to style, which you haven't done yet, or which you want to do?
Shobhana.
An actor?
Fahad.
Okay, cool.
I'm dying to work with him.
Okay. Fahad, you're listening.
The hands down, the finest actor in India right now.
Yeah.
Nobody's better than him.
Wow, you're such a Fahad fan, huh?
I am a huge Fahad fan, yeah.
And if you want to do one story, which is basically in Malayalam, if you want to do a Malayalam film, and which you want to do a remake of some Hindi film, which one could be? Name a Hindi film which you want to read or remake in Malayalam.
Sadma. Yeah.
Okay. But Tamil is there. Moonambir.
Oh, there is a Tamil version?
It is a Tamil version first, then only came to Sadma.
Okay. Sadma. So Sadma was a remake of a Tamil film.
Yes. Moonambir. By Kamal Haasan and Sridevi.
Yeah.
Any other one?
Any other one? A Hindi film which I would like to remake in Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara. I would love to.
Yeah. For Malayalam movies, itna budget nahi ki Spain ja ke itna shoot karenge.
India mein kar lenge, Munnar leke jayenge.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
So you have not talked about any other industry. Like, have you worked with Tamil and Telugu industry as well?
I have been recently working a lot in Tamil industry because of my friend Malvika.
I know Malvika. Yeah. Please give her. Yeah.
Yes, definitely. So I work on Master right now. I'm working with Dhanush on a film. So yeah.
Okay. So when are we meeting in Chennai? When you come to see your friend Malvika. Malvika is in Bombay, right?
Malvika is in Bombay. She's a Bombay girl. She's born and brought up.
I interviewed her. After that, we have not met her. So please give a big love to her.
I will do that. And you are based in Chennai, right?
Yes, I'm a Chennai person for the last 20 years.
Okay, so whenever we are coming next, we were in Chennai some time back for the shoot. So next we are in Chennai, please meet us.
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
All right, it was a pleasure talking to you. It was so much of a pleasure. You took me to a world of so many other styling, managing superstars, shooting, a person looking at all the process of all the filmmaking. So I'm so happy that I stopped you.
Same, yeah. It was lovely talking.